Anxiety is something that everybody experiences from time to time, and it's mainly situations that you feel you can't control, which is super normal, and probably most of the audience has experienced this before. I feel like the best way to explain stress is when your brain constantly harasses you on activities in your life, and sometimes it can happen way too often. But stress is so much more than that, scientifically speaking, and quite frankly, it's a little bit more complex than my knowledge on this topic. So here's Mr. Causey to deconstruct this complex topic.
In Understanding Abnormal Behavior by Doctors Su Su and Su, they mention in there a biopsychosocial model when it comes to dealing with stress as well as other conditions in our bodies. And in there is a biological component that is the HPA axis, which is the hypothalamic, pituitary, and adrenal glands working together in a response system for our stress, as well as our hormones playing a part of that biological process. To understand stress as a whole, we must first understand a few things. So let's break those things down. In that biopsychosocial model that we see by Doctors Su Su and Su, there's a psychological component, which is the mental portion of how we perceive the world around us, and then our body reacts according to that perception. Then the social model breaks it down into our socioeconomic status as well as our environmental conditions. The biological component speaks to our genetics and our biological responses to stress. So one of those things is the HPA axis, which according to yeastgenome.org is the way our body responds to stress according to the way it was programmed. So the HPA axis is a neuroendocrine system that begins to act without us even thinking about it to respond to stressful conditions. Another thing is hormones is another biological component where we see hormones such as common ones you hear every day like progesterone and testosterone. Depending on the age of development that we're in, those things are higher or lower, or there's a specific balance, and those hormones can play a part in how we respond to stress.
Thank you, Mr. Causey, for sharing your insight on stress. Stress now is way different than the earlier years. This generation seems to live on likes and shares, and sometimes life can be a little demanding. But there is one good thing that comes out of stress, and that is to become more productive. There are a lot of different ways to get stressed out, whether it be your school, job, technology, social media, or family issues, or maybe it's all being thrown at you at once. So here are a few tips to help when you're stressed out. You could try sleeping, exercising, mindful meditation, laugh every once in a while, and relaxing at a cafe with a nice drink. Even though these tips seem relatively simple, they will help you in the long run. Wait, I forgot to study for my test. What am I gonna do to calm down? Deep breathing. Okay, with a couple more of those, I'm gonna be more prepared for this test. Well, I better get studying. I'm Eva Lee signing off of CVTV.